We control change. We can control it. It's up to you, it's up to me, it's up to you, it's up to you. Nothing else. We can control how hard we play. Shame on us if we don't. Leave everything we got out on the floor, right?
Florida, CBS Sports presents the road to the Final Four. We are deep in SEC country for the Florida Gators and the LSU Tigers as we welcome you inside the O'Connell Center. Welcome to Gainesville alongside Doug Gottlieb. I'm Spiro Ditas. We'll start with LSU, a team that had an enormous win earlier this week on Tuesday at home against Kentucky. Really a breakthrough performance in that the supporting cast players kind of proved that this is not just a one-man team around the freshman phenom from Australia, Ben Simmons. But all that said, their story begins and ends with Simmons.
He's as good as advertised and maybe even better. Sure, he hasn't shown the ability to make a lot of three-point shots, but that's because he hasn't taken them. Why take threes when you can get easy twos? He's left-handed, but he finishes with his right hand. He's a scorer, but he likes to pass maybe more than score. And he's a dynamic rebounder and finisher around the basket. Ben Simmons is as good a college prospect as we have seen in the one-and-done era.
Simmons has scored better than 20 points in four of his last five games. You see where he ranks third in the country in rebounds. Just incredible numbers from the first-year kid from Australia. Meantime, the Florida Gators, a team that started well, 7-1 to begin the season, but they have struggled of late, dropping four of their last seven. And you just get the sense that this is a program still trying to figure out life after Billy Donovan. Mike White, their new head coach, has really relied on his upperclassmen, the few that he has, and that starts with Dorian Finney-Smith.
And it's not as much Mike White as much as the team trying to find themselves after losing a senior class that got him to a Final Four 2 years ago. The last of the Mohicans is Dorian Finney-Smith. He's going to have to take the ball at Ben Simmons, try and get him in foul trouble, much the way Kentucky did if Florida wants to be successful. Now you add the old to the new, and the new is Kayvon Allen, who, like most freshmen, starting to come around during conference play. He's given them a dynamic wing scorer, and he'll have to take it as a personal challenge to take and make big shots against the Fighting Tigers.
All right, with that, let's take a look at the AT&T Fast Analysis.
You mentioned it. Everything LSU does starts and ends with Ben Simmons. 6'10", 240 pounds, but he plays like a point guard. He likes to go downhill with his momentum going towards the basket. And if you pick him up with the center, he'll take him to the basket and draw a foul. And if you help around Craig Victor, their new low post player who got eligible after semester, that allows Keith Hornsby to show he has range from three. As for the Gators, they come off their worst performance of the season, blown out, eviscerated by the Vols because of plays like this. No transition defense. And then when they did get back defensively, not identifying the personnel of the Vols, leaving players wide open. Tennessee took it to Florida from the time they threw it up until the final buzzer. Let's see if Florida reacts to the blowout up in Knoxville this week.
Oh, monstrous chance for the Gators to get their season back on course against the consensus number one player in the country. The tip is next on CBS. Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by AT&T, mobilizing your world. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Pick Enterprise, we'll pick you up. And by Bud Light, make the right call. Drink responsibly. Johnny Jones, fourth season at the helm of this LSU men's basketball program. You see his record, let them to the NCAA tournament last year, their first appearance in the Big Dance since 2009. Third time he's led a team into the NCAA tournament. Couple at North Texas in his long tenure leading that university. Here are his starters today, the guards. They go three-guard alignment. Tim Quarterman coming off one of the best all-around games of his career against Kentucky. And then up front, Ben Simmons, the young man who needs no introduction. And Craig Victor, who has really been a key addition for them. Kayvon Allen, you heard Doug mention him in the open. Chris Chiosa, very steady sophomore point guard. And John Igbudu, who entered the year as perhaps their most intriguing prospect. Sat out last year after transferring from USF. As you see, Mike White, the 38-year-old head coach, big shoes to fill here after the exit of Billy Donovan in late April, Doug, after 19 years.
And Florida, a team that does not shoot the ball well, but they generate their offense off of energy from the defensive end, and then when they do score, they like to pick up full court and pressure.
A little over a week ago, the word on this LSU team was that it was an underachieving group, would struggle to make the NCAA tournament, but suddenly a couple of wins over Vanderbilt and Kentucky earlier this week, and suddenly the perception around this team has changed dramatically. Dorian Finney-Smith getting the party started with a little mid-range J.
And you saw the little isolation for the veteran. Florida's gonna try and feed Finney-Smith till he burps early on.
Preseason second team All-SEC selection. Tigers 9-5 to start the season. A team that has won five of its last six. Victor had it stripped. Here comes Allen. Chiosa from deep. Offensive rebound. Igbunu had it ripped away. And look at the big fella getting his hands dirty. Jump ball is called, and the possession arrow favors LSU. But already, Doug, you like the activity from this Florida team that really was run out of the gym earlier this week in Knoxville.
They were run out of the gym, but you see the energy of Mike White as he's encouraging his bench. You can't get a better couple of possessions where, one, you get the easy open shot that you designed, you get to set up your press, and then you get a steal from Kayvon Allen, low post.
This is Simmons in the open floor. Simmons struggled the other night, just 9 minutes in the first half in a win over Kentucky. He's in foul trouble. Geo's up the floor. Finney-Smith getting to the free throw line. And a chance at a three-point play.
Now, Ben Simmons had a drive to the basket, but when he misses, he doesn't sprint back defensively. Poor communication in Dorian Finney-Smith. Dodo, as he's known, shows great energy and gets the ball in transition, has a chance to end one.
He's been a little up and down. Lone senior. Here Mike White's rotation, really the last holdover from that team a couple of years ago that went to the Final Four.
They didn't just go to the Final Four. They went to three straight Elite Eights. They went undefeated in SEC play and then went to the Final Four. An unbelievable group.
Good start for Florida, 5-0. LSU looking for its first points. This is Quarterman. Gets inside, offensive foul against Quarterman.
Now, Johnny Jones's biggest fear today, because Tim Quarterman played so well, he said, I sat down next to Tim Quarterman at our meal this morning, and I said, look, I know that you had your best game in weeks, but that doesn't mean you shoot it the first five times you touch it. And you see Tim Quarterman already out after that offensive foul. We'll see how he adjusts to the officiating, adjusts to the pressure, suddenly being a guy that everybody's watching on the scouting report.
Nearly had a triple-double in that win over Kentucky the other night. There's a traveling violation called Dorian Finney-Smith.
You can get a sense for what Florida's trying to do offensively. They're simply isolating Dorian Finney-Smith with a ball screen on his own side of the floor. And to this point, LSU is switching. They want to go at Ben Simmons and get him into foul trouble. But instead, they're getting a small point guard on Dorian Finney-Smith, which is an equally good matchup, if not better.
What a pass. Simmons finding his man Victor, who misses the little chip shot. Last touch out of bounds by Florida, 17 to shoot.
You mentioned the passing. They just put him in the middle against his zone press. The one question for Ben Simmons is, we know he can pass, but will he take over games offensively, scoring the basketball when his team needs it?
Simmons wide open, drains the shot. You see him turn around and stare down the student section.
A little peek at the reptiles.
Well, here's the amazing thing about Simmons. This is the fourth true road game that he has played at any level in
his life,
basketball life. There's that one is knocked out of bounds, 19 to shoot. Played in the junior league in Australia. They basically played in empty gyms, neutral sites. Played at Montverde Academy just outside Orlando, where they played all their games at home or on neutral sites. This is all new to him, having road fans kind of scream at him, taunt him. Unbelievable as the offensive putback attempt by Leon. Let's see if they'll count it.
That should be a goaltend. And Byron Jarrett properly calls it a goaltend. Yeah, that's an unbelievable statistic. And Johnny Jones said, you know, this is only his fourth road game. I said, of course, fourth road game of the year. We can read the schedule code. It's like, no. He never played on the road in Australia. Play junior games, you play before the bigger teams. It's no road environment. Nobody's cheering against you. And he was great last week against Vanderbilt. They went into Memorial and just thumped the door.
Here's Keith Hornsby getting to the free throw line. This kid is a tank, as he'll shoot two. Missed the first seven games of the season, had a minor surgical procedure in early November. We asked Johnny Jones about Hornsby yesterday, and he said in his 30-plus years of coaching, this is the hardest working kid he's ever been around.
Two shots.
Of course, Hornsby is the son of great musician Bruce Hornsby. You know, you have the Bruce Hornsby in the range on your iTunes account, do you not?
Absolutely. This is Chioza. 7-4 Gators lead with just under 3 minutes gone by. Finney Smith.
That same ball screen and isolate. Now the question is, can he get Ben Simmons into foul trouble?
Simmons called for the contact, and this is the area of Simmons' game, maybe the only minor weakness that's been talked about, an occasional lethargic defensive stance. Not
this time. Finney-Smith going right at him, and Ben Simmons reaches in and gets called for a foul. You mentioned only 9 minutes in the first half the other day against Kentucky. That was because of foul trouble. Only plays 20 minutes. That's the biggest challenge for most freshmen, is to learn how to defend. Play harder than you've ever played, yet play under control, and do so without fouling.
So early foul issues. Tim Quarterman already on the bench for LSU, two personals, and Simmons picks up his first at the 17-minute mark of this opening half. 5-point lead for the Gators. This is Josh Gray, come on for Quarterman. Alley-oop, Simmons there, try to put it in over the shoulder, and it rolls off. Chioza. Nice ball movement, Vinnie Smith. Underneath it, Kudu couldn't handle it. Here comes Blakeney, the other highly touted incoming freshman. What a find, Simmons showing the court vision.
Josh Gray.
Josh Gray open. Josh Gray makes it after the Ben Simmons miss. LSU has stabilized themselves.
You've heard the comparisons to some of the greats, Magic Johnson, LeBron James, as Gray Smith hits another mid-range shot. That's unfair to the kid, but one thing about his game, you watch him, he just seems to enjoy passing more than he does scoring.
He's a natural passer. He cannot teach players how to pass.
That's Blakeney struggling from the outside. That has been the area where he is still getting comfortable. The incoming freshman, that outside shot. That's Kayvon Allen, the freshman who's led them in scoring each of the last four games.
That's the one weakness to his game. He's an outstanding scorer, but not yet a great shooter from three. That's the problem with most of this Florida team.
Simmons, that one-handed lefty pass to the cutter, Hornsby. Last touch by the Gators, as LSU will have it when we come back down five on CBS. Early 5-point lead for the Gators with just under 16 to play before halftime. Oh, following the likes of Billy Donovan would be difficult for any head coach, let alone a 38-year-old guy with only 4 years of previous head coaching experience. But Mike White at 38, what a run he had, 4 years at Louisiana Tech. He was the only man that the AD of Florida, Jeremy Foley, interviewed for the vacancy. That surprised some people.
And what's interesting is Mike White, of course, played at Ole Miss as a point guard for Rod Barnes up for the Rebs. His wife, Kira, grew up in the state of Florida, was a volleyball player at Ole Miss. That's where they met. They have five children. She started crying when she thought he could get the job because her dream was always to play volleyball at UF, and just the thought of being a chance to be part of this campus was something special there.
That's Victor trying to muscle it in. And her dream was to play for Mary Wise, the longtime legendary women's volleyball coach here in Florida. As Giosi's shot is partially deflected in the putback by Faye Smith. Second chance, offensive rebound. It's Leon making his third straight start. 7-point Gators lead. Hornsby's going to try from deep. Rims out. Fight for the loose ball. It's Kayvon Allen. And contact from Josh Gray. Manner came on to replace Tim Quarterman, who's already on the bench with a couple of fouls.
And as Chioza goes in and misses the shot, there's Dorian Finney-Smith and the no box out from Ben Simmons. It's these little things that you have to clean up, even when you're a superstar.
That's Leon trying to show his range. Rebound pulled by Hornsby. And can LSU get its offense on track? Simmons hounded on the perimeter.
You see Kayvon Allen, who's coming in and trying to get a steal in the low post, and every time Simmons puts it on the deck.
Simmons turning the corner, banks it in. Absorbing contact, the freshman thought he was fouled.
Everybody thought he was fouled. That's 15 yards, personal foul across the street.
Vicious letting him play early in his first half.
But you saw how he finished with his right hand. He does everything with his right hand except for shoot a basketball from the perimeter.
Gators looking a little bit stagnant. Five to shoot. Gioza from deep. Offensive rebound. Boy, Leon's been huge to start this game. Leon, the junior, Arkansas native, inserted into the lineup just as they began their SEC schedule, and he has had a quick impact. This is Blakeney. 10 to shoot. Hornsby for deep. Offensive rebound, and that is Victor. What a difference he has made in the six-plus games since debuting on December the 16th.
And he's got kind of a funky shot, but as you pointed out, Johnny Jones told us, hardest worker he's ever been around. It's just about repetition and confidence. He has worked so hard at his jump shot. And it goes in despite the fact it looks a little funky from his arm angles.
Leon underneath. This is Ekpunu, surrounded by three defenders, and he's going to get the foul call anyway.
Let me go back to the previous possession, Spiro, and here's what's going on. The Gators are trying to run an alley-oop play. They're trying to come over and set a back screen and run the alley-oop as Chris Chioza catches the basketball. And LSU does a good job of snuffing it out. But then when the shot goes up, nobody puts a body on the extra body. And LSU is not rebounding as a team. So they're doing a good job against the initial rush of Florida's offense against the zone. But sometimes you just have to search out a man. And Antonio Blakeney did not box anybody out in the previous possession. That's far too easy for the Gators.
You see John Ekpunu at the free throw line, sat out last year after the transfer. Nigerian born. So he practiced all of last season against both Chris Walker and John Harford. And the word was that kind of had his way with him. In the practice gym.
Very good low post score when he was out South Florida. I called one of their games. He just had to lose some weight. He did. Not a very good free throw shooter, obviously.
Jalen Patterson, Brandon Sampson have come on for the Tigers. Here is Gray, muscles his way inside.
Josh Gray's a big-time scorer. Up 34 a game in junior college. What an incredible personal story we'll try and touch on later with Josh Gray.
And that was at Odessa College, Community College in Texas. Three-point game, LSU getting a little bit closer. Ekpunu under control and that soft touch underneath.
Yeah, if you butt up, if you play right behind John Ekpunu, he's going to eat. He's going to go and score off both shoulders, left and right. Nice soft hands and good finishing touch.
Simmons right down Broadway, and he'll shoot free throws.
Therein lies the rub with Ben Simmons, because they run the type of ball screens you rarely see or maybe never see in a season. So Dorian Finney-Smith is the power forward for this lineup. Ekpunu is the center. That's a 4-on-5 ball screen. That doesn't happen. Usually it's the point guard with the ball and the power forward to the center setting the ball screen. And so you have normal rotations. There's no normal rotation for that. Later on in the game, you'll see them, when they bring Hornsby back in, they'll have Hornsby set the ball screen for Ben Simmons. Because if you help on Simmons, he'll kick it out to Hornsby for a jump shot. So Johnny Jones said, look, he's doing things within his offense he's never coached before. No one else has to coach this way because no one's had a weapon like Ben Simmons who can handle like a point guard and play the power forward.
Well, he doesn't sit very often, but he'll get a quick blow here. 5 points, 3 boards, and an assist for the freshman.
One personal foul, and Johnny Jones gets him out knowing the TV timeout is coming for the next dead ball.
Now you talk about all the issues that Simmons presents and the weapons that Johnny Jones suddenly has at his disposal. Just past the 12-minute mark, first half, here's Casey Hill. Coming off the bench, sets the table for Finney Smith. Offensive rebound, Devin Robinson comes down into his own teammate. Allen, who's been quiet till this point, and the freshman with a pretty little floater.
Kayvon Allen's a bucket getter. Bucket getter's the guy, there's no one refined skill that he has. He just finds ways to score in transition, in the mid-range, off the steal.
Nice backdoor cut by Jalen Patterson, the sophomore who's just come in but couldn't finish. Kayvon Allen had 32 here the other day. Most points by a freshman in the O'Connell Center since Joakim Noah went to 37 in March of 06. This kid's got a world of talent.
Well, you said world of talent. That's Ben Simmons. Scoring, passing, rebounding, hitting jump shots. The O-Domes get to see the entire repertoire on display early. Gators up 6.
Six-point lead for the Gators with just over 11 minutes to play in this first half. Doug, what have you seen so far from Ben Simmons?
So people ask, you know, who is Ben Simmons? Everybody needs a comparison. What if he's a bit of everybody? You know, he's got that body. He's a little bit bigger than a young LeBron James, also a point power forward. I think he has vision like Magic Johnson. People forget, Magic Johnson wasn't a great shooter when he came out of Michigan State. And he has that kind of lefty feel and the ability to play inside and out like a Lamar Odom. We got a little bit of all of them. He was actually an outstanding Australian rules football player, and at a young age had to decide which way he wanted to go. He's got some of that Aussie toughness to him as well. He did play some AAU, but for the most part spent his summers back home in Australia. So he's got a little bit of everything to him. What a special talent, and kind of a regal way which he carries himself in. There?
Yes, absolutely. And I have to say, a very, very subtle Australian accent. Kind of threw me off a little bit.
You're big on that. You were.
I was expecting more.
Well, he said Darcy Malone is also from Australia, more from the country, and he has more of an Australian country accent, which is a little bit thicker. He said it's a lot like the American kind of country accent, has more of a twang.
We asked Johnny Jones about him, and he told us about the phone call he got from Simmons when Simmons told him he was committing to the school. Johnny said he was driving to Baton Rouge to give a speech, and Simmons called him on the phone and he said, "Coach, I'm coming." And Johnny just thought he was coming to Baton Rouge to hang out and meet. He said, "No, Coach, I'm committing to LSU. I'm coming to the program." Jones said he nearly drove off the road. Said he had goosebumps. Just thinking of what kind of program Simmons' arrival would allow him to build over the season. Here comes Allen. Freshman. Extending. Gorgeous finish from Kayvon Allen. Dorian Finney-Smith. Two personals now on the Gators bench. So both teams dealing with some first half foul trouble. Simmons wants to take Leon, and he is hacked.
Here's Kayvon Allen in transition, Spiro. As you see the speed and athleticism of the freshman guard just stealing the ball and swooping down. And when Mike White got the job, before he ever stepped on campus here in Gainesville, the first stop that the Florida Gator plane made was actually in Little Rock because he had to re-recruit Kayvon Allen, who had committed to play for the Gators in Billy Donovan.
You know, White said he watched the Billy Donovan goodbye press conference like everyone else at that point, had no idea that he would be here. Less than a week later, was announced as the head coach. Team sent a plane to pick him up, and he said before he came to Gainesville, he made the stop in Little Rock. First order of business was to get Allen to recommit And obviously a pretty good sell job as the freshman is here and really starting to come into his own over the last couple of weeks.
Three of the four commitments that Billy Donovan had reaffirmed their commitments to play for the Gators. They were just 16 and 17 last season.
Nice floater from Casey Hill. The young man whom they recruited a couple of years ago, really to be the heir apparent to Scotty Wilbekin. This has not panned out till this point. Actually went to White and told him he wanted to come off the bench. Thought that the move would take some of the pressure off him. Here's Hill trying to beat the defense and stuffs it with a right hand.
High school teammate of Ben Simmons, highly decorated and trying to live up to it as the Gators have the O-Dome rocket.
They'll never miss a moment with the CBS Sports app. Every play and every score for college basketball, wild card weekend, the college football championship, and more. Download the CBS Sports app today. Spiro Dinas, Doug Gottlieb, our entire CBS crew from Gainesville. They are full throat here in the O-Dome. As the Gators have opened up their biggest lead of this first half. Casey Hill has a couple of buckets and successive trips. And Simmons will fall away. Baby hook shot and a rebound pulled by Ebunu. You see the drop from the Tigers now stretching over 3.5 minutes.
Well, they've been playing without Tim Quarterman, who has two personal fouls. Remember, he gave them a big spark when Simmons was in foul trouble. And Johnny Jones sticking to that hard and fast sit you with two fouls rule.
Outside looking three from Brandon Francis Ramirez, a freshman from the Dominican Republic. Contact as Simmons dribbles it up the floor. So this kind of a different set of circumstances than LSU had against Kentucky earlier this week. Simmons was the guy in foul trouble, played just 9 minutes in the first half. The supporting cast really elevated the team. And now Simmons with a couple of his key teammates on the bench trying to figure things out. What a pass! Simmons underneath, finding Aaron Epps. Unbelievable court vision from the freshman sensation. 8-point game as we come up on 8 minutes left before halftime. Freshman a little bit short on the floater. Here comes Simmons. Victor calling for the post up. Nice seal of Ebunu. And a foul charge to the Florida big man.
I mentioned he's just a natural passer. And that's just a beautiful pass. Ebunu's just watching the ball. He's in ball, you man. Perfect help position. And Simmons throws it up over his head to Epps, who smartly cuts towards the basket.
Number 32, Skylar River.
You can work on players' fundamentals. You can teach them the age-old rule, which is first man open gets the basket. You can't teach players to have vision. And it's so rare that you have a great player who truly enjoys making the game easier for others.
Here comes Patterson, good-looking floater. No basket, offensive foul.
That's big for Devin Robinson, another highly touted Gator recruit who hasn't been as productive as they would have hoped here in Gainesville. Patterson played really well off the bench against Kentucky. You mentioned the bench.
Robinson began the season as a reserve, then moved into the starting lineup in late November. But to back to the reserve unit as they have started their SEC schedule. Shot clock down to 11. Hill into the corner for Chiozzi. 7 to shoot. Hill. That's a long 2. And the rebound pulled by Patterson. Tigers have tightened up their defense. Patterson, the sophomore, now to Gray. Where do the Tigers go here? With 11 to shoot. Simmons. Underneath. Contact, no call. Long rebound, tracked down by Epps. Shot clock resets for LSU. Victor. And right through the defense, but couldn't finish. Casey Hill, contact and a reaching foul charge to Gray. LSU's bench screaming for a travel. 8-point Florida lead on CBS. Back with you in Gainesville, 8-point lead for the Gators, which just done a 7th play before halftime. Spiro Dinas and Doug Gottlieb with you. We saw LSU kind of struggle dealing with some foul trouble with some key starters. What have you seen so far?
Well, they haven't matched the energy of the Gators, Florida Gators, on the offensive board. UF is a terrible three-point shooting team, 17th worst three-point shooting team in the country. But sometimes their best offense is simply throwing it up and going and getting it. They got 7 offensive boards on 13 misses. I think it's been about the effort of the Gators on their own offensive glass and LSU not matching that intensity. Just a little bit of what we're talking about. As well as Ben Simmons has played, loses Dorian Finney-Smith, gives him an extra opportunity, chooses not to foul, and Florida gets an easy bucket. Then Dorian Finney-Smith throws up a brick. Devin Robinson tips it out, and it gives Kayvon Allen the chance to get a runner going towards the basket. In the half court, Mike White's team really struggles to score. They scored a couple buckets in transition, and they've gotten 7 offensive rebounds. That's a recipe for disaster for LSU, especially in foul trouble.
Casey Hill at the free throw line hits the front end. And we asked White about what happened in Knoxville the other night. Basically shrugged his shoulders, and he said, we haven't even had a practice that poorly. Or that poor, I should say. Gators were down by as many as 30 in that game. Kevin Punter of Tennessee just lit him up. 26 points in that game. And Florida was just never competitive.
Says it all right there. We're at the free throw line with a 9-point lead. We miss a free throw around and out. Now all of a sudden we give Ben Simmons 2 free ones.
White, a stellar 4-year run at Louisiana Tech. 27 plus wins in each of his last 3 years. Simmons, a 74% free throw shooter. And LSU inching a little bit closer now within 7. Johnny Jones has his Tigers still in that 2-3 zone defense.
Got Antonio Blakeney back in the game, who hasn't given them much offensively. We'll see if that changes after a rest.
Gio's a deep 3. One-handed putback attempt rims out from Devon Walker. Simmons across the paint, going glass. The freshman wonder kind starting to leave his imprint on this game. Deep looking 3, that's Kayvon Allen. Walker hands off to Robinson, who can't hit the 3.
Well, they've given up 2 consecutive offensive rebounds to Florida, but luckily Florida hasn't been able to make them pay.
Patterson. One dribble to set up the shot, but he has struggled to this point. Tigers have basically played this entire first half without Tim Quarterman. Picked up 2nd early personal. Was their best all-around player the other night in that big win at home against Kentucky.
Hornsby has 2 as well. They're saddled with fouls at the
Allen, swallowed up by Victor. A defensive gem from the Arizona transfer. Ball knocked out of bounds, they say, last touch by the Tigers.
We mentioned Kayvon Allen would prefer to drive than to shoot 3s, and he drives right into the trees, and Greg Victor says, welcome to the SEC, little fella. Victor, of course, left after just 10 games at Arizona. Boy, has he been productive. They love his ability to score in the low post and face up and shoot as well.
What a pass! Chioza backdoor to Robinson, skying for the finish. Since Victor became eligible, LSU has won 5 of 6. This is Patterson for 3. Hasn't been bashful despite the struggles. Chioza fouled on the pass.
Now we're going to talk about all the great things Ben Simmons does. Let's talk about the poor things. Here he is taking a deep breath defensively, worrying a little bit about Kayvon Allen. And he loses Devin Robinson, who's just a pogo stick. Tremendous athlete. Chioza throws it right next to the rim. When you're the backside of that zone, you have to drop to the level of the lowest man on the floor and make him run through your body.
A heroic, emotional, and heartbreakingly real, a powerful new Code Black you won't want to miss. Wednesday, 10, 9 Central, only CBS. 12,000 here at the O'Connell Center. Gainesville, Florida. Spiro Vitas, Doug Gottlieb, rest of our CBS crew. Florida and LSU, both teams at 9-5. Gators 1-1 in the SEC. LSU 2-0. A team that comes in surging after a couple of conference wins against Vanderbilt and Kentucky. Top of the key three from Blakeney. A freshman from Sarasota, Florida, as they get a deflection at the other end. And this is where Blakeney needs to kind of step up his game.
It's not just the unselfishness, okay? It's the fact that he delivers the ball in rhythm. And if there's one thing I can relate to with Ben Simmons, is passing the basketball. And that pass in Blakeney's hands, in his chest, in his rhythm, not too hard, not too soft.
And meantime, that back end of the LSU defense continues to be very soft. Egbunu with the hammer.
Well, that was the same alley-oop play they ran earlier in the game, and LSU has not adjusted to it.
A whistle-blown offensive foul on LSU.
Here it is again. Florida continues to run the same set. Most everybody in college basketball runs this. You simply come over and set a little screen. Devin Walker barely puts any meat on the back end of that defense. But it's just enough.
Florida's lead back to 7. Allen can't get the friendly bounce, but Robinson inside to clean it up. This is Elbert Robinson underneath the cutting Patterson. What a find by the big fella Robinson. 7-point Gators lead. We come up on 3 minutes left before the break. This is Chris Chioza, the sophomore from Memphis. Gators reset, 15 to shoot. Egbunu. And his foul just as he put it on the deck. Patterson collapsing down to help Robinson.
If there was a trampoline in the key, it wouldn't surprise me, because Devin Robinson just explodes and finishes. Gators doing chin-ups, offensive rebound drills. Up big.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, Adam Zucker, Clark Kellogg, and Seth Davis analyze the first half. Get you updated on what's happening today in college basketball around the country. It's all next on AT&T at the half. The inside play from the Gators has been the difference.
Yeah, let me help the boys out at Studio 43 out. This has been the key. Florida dominating the glass, throwing it up, and going and getting it. Florida's 0 of 11 from three-point range. But they continue to lead by 7 because they're dominating on the glass. 22 points in the paint, 10 offensive rebounds. And Spiro, my question is, either one, why is LSU in their zone? Because they're not boxing out well in the zone. They're not finding the slashers for those alley-oop pass out of the zone. And if you're going to stay in a zone, why not play, Tim Quarterman, who's got 2 personal fouls. Why not play Keith Hornsby, who's got 2 personal fouls?
Egbunu only a 57% free throw shooter. Monday, don't miss an all-new late show with Stephen Colbert. Stephen's got Angel from Hell star Jane Lynch. Then catch James Corden all-new Monday, only CBS. We asked Johnny Jones about his rule of sitting guys that pick up a second personal in the first half. He says it's a hard rule. Quarterman and Hornsby have basically been on the bench, Doug, the entire first half. What's your response?
I disagree greatly. I think that's a... It depends on the player, depends on the game, depends on the situation. He said with Simmons, he might have played a deal tonight had he not played so well against Kentucky.
What a pass. Chioza underneath, but Walker couldn't finish. Jones says as long as his team is within around 10 points or so striking distance, he'll stick to his guts. 2.5 to play first half. This is Blakely, the freshman, who swatted on a little putback attempt, step back, I should say. Casey Hill has played well off the bench in this first half.
And look, it worked for him the other night as Tim Quarterman, and you see him sitting next to Keith Hornsby. Blakely kind of forcing, got a little thirsty here. Hasn't gotten any shots, instead forces one. But in this game, again, if you're going to sit in the zone, if you're going to go man-to-man and guard somebody where one of your players could be in foul trouble, or if they're younger, inexperienced players, I would agree with you.
Simmons setting up Patterson for the three.
Oh,
and look at Blakely sneak in for the offensive rebound. Double bonus. So it will be Antonio Blakely to the free throw line, the freshman, five-star prospect out of Sarasota, Florida.
Antonio Blakely initially committed to Louisville, then decided to open up his commitment. Went to LSU. He struggled with his jump shot, but what's special about Antonio Blakely is he has bought into the idea of not allowing that to take away from his defense. They've been very impressed with his defensive intensity.
Well, coming up tonight, 10:30 Eastern on CBS Sports Network, the toughest sport on dirt returns for an all-new season as the Toro hosts the Gold Buckle begins the PBR-built Ford Tough Series Chicago Invitational, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Six-point game in Gainesville, Chioza, as we come up on 2 minutes to play before halftime. Blakely defending Chioza. Finds a spot, dangerous pass to Walker, who then gives it away. Walker's pass is taken back by Hill, and Hill will shoot free throws. Frustration foul by Aaron Epps, the sophomore, and another Louisiana kid. Victor just was never expecting the pass.
Well, why was he throwing it to Craig Victor? Craig Victor doesn't want the ball. That's where Ben Simmons, you want to be the point guard? Go get the basketball. It's Epps' fault for making the pass, but it's Simmons' fault for not demanding the ball and getting out in transition.
So here's Casey Hill, the junior Florida native. Talked about his struggles. He's really struggled at the free throw line. Now just 8 of his last 17 at the stripe, but he has played well both ends in his first half.
And I feel for him. Here's a guy very highly touted, and just the mental game of not putting too much pressure on yourself when people allow you, leave you wide open. You feel almost like they dare you to shoot it. Sometimes you take that dare when you're not shooting the ball well and you don't think it's going to go in. That's Casey Hill's problem.
Whistle blown away from the ball. This is against the Gators.
Florida foul is on number 3, Devin Robinson, his second.
The LSU now, you got them in the double. You got the Gators in the double bonus. You can make some free throws, get it under 5. With all the foul trouble you've had, Florida has outplayed them, outworked them, out-hustled them. That's the only reason Florida has a lead. You feel pretty good about yourself.
Still a 1-1 situation, so Simmons will step to the free throw line. Simmons 74% on the season. Now here's the other thing about Simmons. Here's a 19-year-old freshman who has garnered basically every possible accolade imaginable. National High School Player of the Year, McDonald's All-American, preseason All-American, only the 4th ever freshman to garner that distinction in the history of the sport. We had a chance to spend some time with him yesterday. He is as grounded and polished a kid as you could expect, considering all the hype around him. Simmons misses on the back end, but Greg Victor getting his hands dirty.
That's that Aussie in it, man. I'm telling you, those Aussies, they don't take anything too seriously. They just want to compete, win. Maybe go out and have a cold one afterwards.
Double bonus now, 2 free throws for Victor. A 50% free throw shooter over his first 6 games as a Tiger.
That's 2. LSU really fortunate there, because that would have been a foul on Epps, but it's a 2-shot foul. Watch how quickly Craig Victor gets rid of it after his second dribble. There's a lot of places he'd like to be. It doesn't appear like the free throw line is one of them.
Doug, I know we haven't seen much of Hornsby in this first half, but they get Hornsby back. Victor now added to the fold. What's the ceiling, do you think, for this LSU team with all these guys helping?
Well, I mean, I think it comes down to the defensive intensity and rebounding and toughness, because they have multiple ball handlers, multiple scorers. Hornsby gives them experience as Devon Walker appears to have rolled his ankle here late in the first half. I mean, everyone in college basketball is missing something. There is no there is no Kentucky of last year.
Here's Blakely finding a spot. Casey Hill trying to push tempo, then poked out of bounds by Blakely. With a buck 23 to play in this first half, and the Gators up six. And this is where Devon Walker, we think, may have turned that ankle, right in the middle of your picture.
His ankle a little bit.
Try to get an update on him as quickly as we can.
You ask what's their ceiling? There is no ceiling. This could be a Final Four team. But they're going to have to decide they're going to lock in defensively. There's another team in the country that has a player the likes of Ben Simmons. And Ben Simmons, the way he plays is like a rising tide. It's going to rise all ships.
Robinson on a deep three. We just wonder if any team can challenge Kentucky in the SEC.
A&M maybe the SEC.
Greg Victor and a chance at a three-point play.
Going to fouls under three, Devin Robinson, his third.
That's just a quick post. In transition, Craig Victor sits down on Devin Robinson, who's way too light for Craig Victor.
Third personal on Robinson, the sophomore. So he will sit with under a minute left in this first half. Victor, very workmanlike, New Orleans kid. Prepped at Finley Prep in Arizona. Had his first double-double as a Tiger earlier this week in that win over Kentucky. 15 points and a dozen rebounds. Did not debut for this team until December the 16th. Sitting out after his Arizona transfer. Simmons pass up the floor to Patterson. Poked away, here comes Hill. Bounce underneath to Rimmer. Walker up and under. Going for the loose ball. Contact and a foul on LSU. Double bonus for the Gators. Two free throws with 24.4 to play before halftime.
At the line,
Devarius Hayes, the freshman, and another Florida native will shoot two. 9 of 20 at the line on the season. Yeah. Mike talking about Hayes yesterday, very intelligent player, big scouting report guy, which you don't often hear from a freshman player at the collegiate level.
Now, he has tried to be extremely positive with these freshmen. You know, so many of the holdovers from Billy Donovan last year, there's some negativity around the program just because you come off a Final Four, you're 16 and 17. He wants them to look at the banners and look at all the success and know that they're in the right place and eventually they'll get there.
Well, last year's team missing the NCAA tournament for only the fifth time in Donovan's 19 years. Final 5 seconds before halftime. Patterson looks confused. Victor on a three. Nearly went as it pops in and out. So Florida up by as many as double digits, up three as we reach halftime. Time now for AT&T at the half as we send you to New York at Adam Zucker.
Thank you, Spiro. Coming up on AT&T at the half, Clark, Seth, and I'll get you caught up on all of today's scores and highlights after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports. Buick, proud partner of the NCAA. And by Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. It's the road to the Final Four, taking us through Gainesville, Florida. 12,000 here at the O'Connell Center with the Gators in front of the Tigers, 34-31. Spiro Dedis, Doug Gottlieb with you courtside. If you're Johnny Jones, LSU head coach, you have to be pretty pleased. Down by as many as 10 in the first half. Tim Quarterman and Keith Hornsby, two of their most important players, barely played due to foul trouble, yet they're only down three.
And their zone wasn't particularly good. Florida crushed them on the offensive boards. They're very fortunate that Florida kind of let LSU off the hook. Not kind of, they did let them off the hook. Florida's just 6 of 16 from the free throw line, in addition to being 0 of 12 from three-point range. A golden opportunity for this Gator team to hop out over LSU and make them play catch-up in the second half was not capitalized on, frankly, Spiro.
All right, let's take a look at the Lexus first half stats as LSU ended that first half on a 7-1 run.
Now, we've seen Chris Jackson come in here and have 53 in the O-Dome. We've seen some great teams light this place up, so it's not a bad shooting background. These teams just are not shooting the basketball well. One guy who continues to impress is Ben Simmons, passing the basketball in range, in rhythm. Though he looked bored at times. 12 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists, and nary a turnover. I always want to say nary in a sentence. Seemed to work there. Ben Simmons, workmanlike in the first half.
Now the Tigers have never led down by as many as 10. That was midway through the first half. Gators are still up 9 with about 3:45 left in that first half before the Tigers closed on that 7-1 run over the final 3:30. Spiro Dedis, Doug Gottlieb, our entire CBS crew from the O'Connell Center here in Gainesville. LSU trying to stay perfect in conference play, 2-0 entering this one today. Both teams at 9-5 overall. Florida, meantime, is 1-1 till this point in conference play. Here's Hornsby, just 7 minutes in the first half. Simmons posting up, and a foul charge. Couple of big-time freshmen locking up that time. Simmons against Kayvon Walker. Or Kayvon Allen, I should say. First personal on Allen. Devon Walker, an ankle sprain. His return is questionable. We saw him limp into the locker room for Florida in the first half. Here's Victor with Ekpudu on his back. Some contact, no call. Offensive rebound by Quarterman.
That's what Quarterman gives you, his great.
That's Blakeney on a three, rims out. Blakeney has not been bashful. Ekpudu. Victor just trying to stand him up, and the officials say jump ball. Possession arrow favoring LSU.
What a weird possession. You know, Tim Quarterman came by, and he was supposed to double team or try and strip the ball out, but that's kind of an ole. I understand he has two personal fouls, but just put your body in between him and put both hands up. He lets Craig Victor in a really precarious position. Victor was fortunate to get that call to go his direction.
Here's Quarterman on a three. Barely nicks the rim. Played only 2 minutes in that first half.
Awful shot.
Saw him force one back in the first half. You have to think that the frustration has started to mount for him after spending so much time on the bench. Finney Smith, a little bit short on the floater. Rebound Victor. Quarterman. This is Hornsby. Stepping away. Resourceful finish from Keith Hornsby.
Yeah, kind of awkward, but his game is kind of awkward.
Hornsby, the 50-year senior, Williamsburg native. Such a critical piece for this team. As we told you earlier, missed the first 7 games of the season. But as Johnny Jones has said, really the heart and soul of this LSU team. As Boudou had it poked away, Gioza. Oh, the seas kind of parted for them. Left-handed finger roll, pretty finish. Quarterman, Hornsby beats the defense back. 1-point game as Hornsby starting to have an impact. And Mike White not liking what he's seen early in the half will burn a timeout. Gators up by as many as 10. Getting a little bit closer here in Gainesville. LSU down by as many as 10, cutting it to 1. We've touched on the impact that Keith Hornsby has had since his return. Missed the first 7 games of the season due to injury. He has been a stalwart mainstay for this program since the transfer coming over from UNC Asheville, and since his return to the lineup, LSU 5-2 this season.
And you just look at this last play. He just beats Florida down the floor defensively. Chris Chioza laid the ball in. Somebody else has to be back. Kayvon Allen picks up the ball. No one else back. That's about effort, and that's what's allowed Keith Hornsby to become such a vital part of this team.
Hornsby played his first game of the season on December the 13th, a game in Houston, came off the bench. Since that game, has started the last seven, including this one this afternoon. How do the Gators respond now? Their offense has stalled. That's Budu. Pretty little touch. We've seen a couple of those little hook shots from him in this game. That Budu, born in Nigeria, redshirt sophomore. Still a bit raw, but as you can see, the kid's got some serious potential at both ends of the floor. Waterman set the table for Victor, turned back by Egbunu.
Mike White out of the timeout says, let's get the ball to our big fellas. So what are they going to run? Kayvon Allen's going to set a little cross screen, and then they're going to down screen for the shooter. But here's the great part about it. As Chioza gets the ball and throws it inside, the ball goes out, then back in.
Well-designed play by White, their 38-year-old head coach.
The inside-out basketball.
Finney Smith from deep. Not quite his shot, but he buries the three.
But what happened first? The ball goes inside to Egbunu, and Egbunu is much bigger, both wide and vertically. He's bigger than Craig Victor. Simmons doubles, the three comes.
Ben Simmons absorbing contact, hits the little floater. 14 for Simmons. And a quick foul, meantime, at the other end of the floor.
LSU fouls number 55, Tim Quarterman. His
third personal on Quarterman.
Finney Smith is the beneficiary of Simmons doubling. And Dorian Finney-Smith, 2 years ago, he was known as having the best shot fake in the SEC. People kept going for it. He can hit that jump shot. That would change Florida offensively for the better. A team that really struggles to shoot the three. Today, of course, no exception. They are just 1 of 13 from three-point range.
See, Finney-Smith has some blood on his upper lip.
See, he's hurt. He's not injured. He said, you're hurt. You're like, hurt means stitch me up. Injured means go to the training room.
Such a tough kid. Everything he's been through in his life. Watched his older brother murdered back in 2008 in Virginia, their hometown where they grew up. Officially started his collegiate career at Virginia Tech, transferred here. And that really is where the maturation process began for him. Billy Donovan so instrumental in his growth. And that's the shot he took from Simmons, with a little off arm on that last bucket.
Basketball is a contact sport. No malice.
Kayvon Allen, right down Broadway. Six points for the freshman on 3 of 10 shooting. Simmons, traveling violation.
Ben Simmons needs to shoot the ball. LSU needs to score the ball. Down 6 in Gainesville.
Adam Zucker in New York. Minutes ago in Madison, tied in the final seconds. Maryland's Melo Trimble from way out to deliver the win. Scores 13 of the Terps' last 17, a game-high 21. And Maryland off for their best start in school history at 15-1. Back to Gainesville.
So we talked about really no dominant team in college basketball, but boy, you can put Maryland right in that upper crust.
They were my pick to win the national championship to start the year. Now, they lost Deion Wiley, who would have been their starting two guard, but remember, they have Rashid Suleiman, who transferred in from Duke. They have Robert Carter, transferred from Georgia Tech. Melo Trimble back, who's as good a player as there is in the country. It's the first time in my life I believe I agree with Seth Davis. Their ceiling may be the highest of anybody's in the country. They're one guard short.
This is Chioza in the corner. Under 16 minutes to play, second half. Gators have led by as many as 10 if you've just joined us. Shot clock down to 6. This is Allen, the freshman. Starts on a dime. And left it a little bit short. Allen has struggled, just 3 of 11 shooting. There comes Simmons, contact and a foul. Simmons now starting to call his number a little bit more as he senses that his teammates are struggling to get their offense going.
Many people know the story that his godfather, David Patrick, of course, on the staff here at LSU, a big part of the reason that he came to Baton Rouge. David Patrick previously was an assistant coach in college at St. Mary's, where he brought so many Australians, including Patty Mills, who was a ball boy for David Patrick and Ben Simmons' dad team when they played together professionally in Australia.
That's right. Patrick lived with Ben's dad, David. He's his godfather. Those two played professionally in Australia. So that Ben used to run on the floor as a kid at halftime of those games. And what a future he's got in front of him. Simmons, 16 points, 9 rebounds, as already he approaches a double-double.
Ford is trying to get the ball inside to Igbunu every possession.
What a play by Justin Leon, going bless. Igbunu to the bench, picking up his third personal dangerous pass, trying to locate Hornsby as LSU turns it over.
So much attention on the other players. Tim Quarterman, who's more of a perimeter defender, you can get right to his chest. That's exactly what happened with Justin Leon. Leon's played quite well.
See the turnover numbers. Quarterman, by the way, playing with three personals. Didn't want to take a chance on that last defensive sequence. Allen finds his spot, continues to struggle. Allen, their leading scorer, the freshman, each of the last 4 games, averaging better than 22 points. Offensive foul, that's on Simmons. 11 LSU turnovers. Second personal on Simmons.
Pretty good call. Simmons has to learn to take the open jump shots. He's a bit of a perfectionist. That's one reason I think he's not taking as many jump shots as he can.
Other thing about Simmons, he's not that emotional on the floor, and you like that. Very even-keeled. It's Chiosa a little bit too strong, and Simmons fighting off the defender. Took around the rebound. Well, Simmons not the only highly touted freshman in this game. We've been talking about Kayvon Allen, a couple of nifty little floaters earlier, but overall struggling as he's missed 9 of his 12 shots.
And it's almost unfair to Kayvon Allen, who's really done a nice job for Florida here, stepping up and scoring the last couple of games. Compare him to Ben Simmons, who's the number one prospect in the country, as a dominant physical specimen.
Devon Walker back on the floor, left in the first half with an ankle injury. And you see him kind of limping up the court. Give that kid all kinds of credit. Allen!
And that's where Kayvon Allen is in his office, driving to the basket. He's probably only 6'1 and a half. A scoring guard from North Little Rock. But boy, can he get buckets in a hurry.
Hornsby kicks out. This is Blakeney from 3. Got it! Second 3 from Blakeney. Entered the day just 27% from 3 on the season. And just like that, LSU within 5. Quickly quiets this crowd of about 12,000. Here's Allen turning the corner. Robinson thought about the 3. 7 to shoot. Walker playing on that gimpy ankle. Off balance run and try to bank it in. Here comes Quarterman, 3 out of 2. Sets the table for Hornsby. 3-point game.
That's great basketball from LSU. From the Hornsby dish to Blakeney for 3, to a defensive stop to another layup. That's the type of winning basketball plays LSU has to make. Let me show you how that 3 came to be. This is very simple. The old UCLA offense, Spiro. In the UCLA offense, when you pass to the wing, you make a UCLA cut. But Heath Hornsby knows there's no help when he catches the ball, so he just drives it. He breaks off the offense. The help comes. Unselfishly, he dishes it to Blakeney for 3.
Devon Walker just didn't look right, trying to come back on that ankle. He was quickly replaced by Mike White.
You look for signs for teams to figure it out, to get it. If they get good leadership. If Keith Hornsby with the pass for three, then the run out, and the team buying in defensively and getting a couple of stops.
This is Casey Hill, the junior point guard. Now to Leon. Dangerous pass is intercepted by Quarterman. Here comes Quarterman, dropping a dime for Simmons, who's fouled, trying to one-hand it through with a left hand.
And part of the problem for Florida is when they don't have John Igbunu in the game, they don't have a low post player to throw to. And Quarterman with a nice steal and then an alley-oop. Jason Hill fouls his former teammate. That was called on the ground? How's that possible?
Officials will say no shot. That's the question that Johnny Jones is asking as well. Contact came with Simmons in midair.
Catching an alley-oop that he was going to dunk.
So side out of bounds. This is Quarterman. Still plenty of time to shoot.
That same UCLA into a ball screen.
This is Simmons. Wants to take Leon. Goes baseline. Off balance. Bank. No. Victor on a putback. No. But he'll shoot free throws. And now LSU starting to flex its muscle on the interior. Third personal. Charge to Robinson.
He'll shoot two shots. As it seems, Ford is still up 3 points.
Coming up Wednesday on CBS, television's number one suspense thriller is back. New year, new criminal minds. Wednesday, 9, 8 Central, only CBS. Both coaches making some changes. Simmons will catch a break. Aaron Epps, the sophomore, will check back in. Averaging around 6 points, just under three boards on the season. Victor gets one of two. And it's a two-point Florida lead. Casey Hill defended by Quarterman. A dangerous pass by Allen. Was somehow fielded by Hayes. Bulked away, gets it back, and then Victor knocks it away again. This is Schuyler Rimmer. Florida out of sorts, to say the least. And boy, they're going to be bailed out by a call here against LSU. That'll drive Johnny Jones crazy. Two-point game on CBS. CBS Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by Verizon. Better matters. Sonic, this is how you Sonic. And by USAA, join us at salutetoservice.com. Now coming up tonight, the NFL on CBS keeps the playoff party rolling with the AFC wild card. It's the kind of game Big Ben and the Steelers play even bigger, except A.J. Green and the Bengals certainly have their own playoff baggage to unpack. Fun begins with your Super Bowl 50 team on a special playoff edition of the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines, tonight 7:30 Eastern, right here on CBS Sports. The playoff slate is just about set with two monstrous games coming up today. First kick at just after 4:30 Eastern time.
Who you like? No D'Angelo Williams, right?
That's right.
Pittsburgh.
Boy, that first game's tough too. KC, 10 straight wins. Houston, though, that defense. I think I'll take the Texans in the early game at home.
All right. End of the nightcap on CBS.
Bengals.
I like the Bengals as well.
Here's Kayvon Allen. Straightaway three. Off target. Allen still jacking him up. Now 4-13 shooting. Simmons contact, and the officials say offensive foul.
That's not an offensive foul.
That's the third personal on the freshman from Australia.
He hit him with an elbow, but it's because his face ended up hitting his elbow. He's going to get called for a flagrant foul here.
Ben Simmons, the consensus number one player in the country. As now the officials are looking at the replay.
I don't know how this is a flagrant foul when he's gathering the ball. That's a basketball move by definition. I don't even think it's an offensive foul.
Doug, I can't agree more. The fact that they're even looking at this.
But they're looking at it because there's an elbow to the face, and by rule, if we throw up the rule, you could call this a flagrant foul.
Well, I guess if you look at it that angle.
But they're going to say it's a basketball play.
Exactly.
But I don't even think it was a foul on Ben Simmons.
Officials say just an offensive foul, no flagrant. You see Simmons' numbers till this point. Only the fourth ever freshman in the history of the sport to be selected to the preseason All-America team. And he has been as good as advertised and then some. Third leading rebounder in the country.
He won three national championships, mythical national championships in high school.
Played at Montverde Academy.
With Casey Hill, who just missed that jump shot.
Just outside Orlando. This is Quarterman as we move inside of 11 minutes. Simmons against Remmer. Freshman likes the matchup. Underneath, just kind of ran into the basketball support as he turns it over.
Hey, he's got Remmer on him when he first caught it. Remmer's 7 feet back, and I understand that he still wants to work on his jump shot. He's got the complete green light. He should take that shot.
Leon from deep. That's good. Massive shot for the Gators. Justin Leon with 11. Entered the day averaging only 3 points per game. Simmons fouled on the catch. It's on Kevarius Hayes, the freshman.
Well, this is the first time that Florida's really gotten into their half-court offense. Same offense they ran with Billy Donovan. Just a little ball screen motion, and Justin Leon steps in and knocks down another shot.
Leon began the season coming off the bench. This is his third straight start. And his first double-digit scoring game as a Gator the other night when that lopsided loss in Knoxville had 11, including three threes. Simmons, double team for a moment. Victor on a deep two. A little bit outside of his range. Gators by five as we move past the midway point of this second half. Leon starting to get comfortable.
If it's possible for a big guy to have a heat check, that was a big guy having a heat check.
Johnny Jones will try to get his troops reorganized. 5-point game as both of these teams looking for a critical SEC win. Mike White's Gators up five. Wants to make a late sub here as you see some of the personnel from Johnny Jones and LSU. Such big shoes to fill following a guy like Billy Donovan. 19 years here in Gainesville, but
you know, Billy Donovan's background, similar to Mike White's.
That's right.
Before he got here. Billy Donovan had been in the NCAA tournament during his short tenure at Marshall. Mike White hadn't been in the NCAA tournament, but it completely turned Louisiana Tech around. Both former point guards and
handoff between Simmons and Hornsby deflected out of bounds by Casey Hill with 11 seconds to shoot. Dorian Finney-Smith will check in for Hayes. 9:27 to play, second half of a 5-point game. LSU trying to build off what they did, their big win over Kentucky. As Hornsby goes across the paint. What a finish from the fifth-year senior. 10 points from Hornsby since halftime. Hornsby played just 7 minutes in the first half in foul trouble. Nice bounce underneath Agbunu, then swallowed up by Victor. Foul called and Agbunu to the line for two.
Keith Hornsby, who's an outstanding athlete, just turns the corner and drives right at John Agbunu. Agbunu's kind of playing a one-man zone. They want Craig Victor to shoot jump shots, so Agbunu's not guarded. He's just trying to block every shot. And then Dorian Finney-Smith is playing soft on Ben Simmons. There's not a lot of room for LSU to operate. Just kind of got to go into the heart of the defense.
How good could this kid Igbunu be?
I think he's very good. I mean, he's a legit 6 foot nine, maybe 6'10". He's gotten himself in outstanding shape. He can score with his back to the basket. So few players, because of how physical the game still is in the low post, can score down there. He's got to make some free throws.
Only one of six at the free throw line in this game. As the Gators leaving some points at the free throw line. 4 point game under 9 minutes left. Hornsby. Simmons, traveling violation.
And that's deferring too much to Simmons. Antonio Blakeney's wide open in the weak side corner. As Hornsby and Simmons are playing a two-man game.
Simmons did not have a turnover in the first half. He's had five in the second half. A couple of traveling violations, two offensive fouls. And that last one a couple of minutes ago where just kind of ran into the basketball stanchion underneath. See the Gators officially struggle last couple of minutes. Foul
he's too big
on the
for
catch.
Igbunu is just too big for Craig Victor. Craig Victor can play bully ball with smaller big guys, but he cannot get around John Igbunu. They call it the goal post for big guys. You put both your arms up like they're a goal post, and you make somebody get around you. Craig Victor can't get around it.
Fourth personal on Victor, and that is a huge call against LSU. See Albert Robinson walking to the table will check in.
And Albert Robinson, a big body that matches the size, but is a non-offensive player in comparison to Craig Victor.
Chioza underneath. Magical finish. Up and under against Simmons. Six-point Gators lead. Offensive rebound, Victor. Shot clock resets.
That's John Igbunu. He's simply in a one-man zone there for Florida.
This is Blakeney. And Simmons underneath. Pass knocked out of bounds, and the officials say last touched by LSU.
The Florida Gators hanging around, chomping their way to a lead in Gainesville.
Game summary, 7:35 to play, second half. Florida has led throughout, up by as many as 10. As you see, both teams struggling with their three-point shooting.
Hey, look at the points and the paint difference. That's been the huge key for the Gators. Whether it's driving the basketball or playing second-shot basketball, kind of lived in the lane. LSU couldn't stop in their zone, and LSU's given up far too many easy buckets for a Florida team that can't shoot. This is the game, the gang that can't shoot straight. They are just 2 of 15 from three-point range, 7 of 18 from the free throw line. With those numbers, you should be dominating this game, but they're not because of too many layups.
Officials correcting the call before the break. Last deflection, last touch by Florida. 10 seconds to shoot. This is Tim Quarterman. Thought about the long three, trying to shake Chioza. Pull up three, in and out. Rebound Igbunu. Quarterman just has not been able to find his rhythm, spent so much time in the first half in foul trouble.
I think they were trying to post up Ben Simmons and he couldn't get open.
Here's Casey Hill absorbing some contact. Does not get the friendly roll. Simmons clears. Simmons 16 points, 13 boards. Quarterman, that's a three. Cuts the deficit in half. It's a three-point game. Quarterman, a 34% three-point shooter. His first points of the afternoon.
It's the confidence to take a second one after missing the previous one around and out as the shot clock expired.
Here comes Chioza, had his pocket picked. Loose ball. Chioza diving for it with Robinson. Possession arrow. Well, now looks like we'll get a foul. It's on Robinson and LSU. Now, one other critical score to pass along, Texas A&M. 18-4 run, down double digits late in the second half of that game. Huge win for A&M, but team that a lot of people are talking about now around the country.
And LSU has to go to College Station. And we'll have them the rematch of that in Baton Rouge later on this season. Texas A&M, a talented crew with an outstanding group of transfers as older players and a top 10 recruiting class to boot.
There's Johnny Jones, fourth year as the head coach at his alma mater, 54 years of age, Louisiana native. Can his Tigers pick up a critical road win in the SEC? Simmons like a gazelle off the floor. Hands off to Blakeney, and now the Tigers reset. Quarterman turns the corner. Simmons, offensive rebound swatted, but a foul.
On a bully ball from LSU, as Tim Quarterman never really had rhythm, but he's just so much bigger than Chioza. Legit 6'6 point guard. Simmons, Johnny on the spot, gets a chance to get two free ones and cut this thing to two.
Simmons, 16 points, 15 rebounds, as LSU inches a little bit closer. Coming up Thursday, an all-new night of comedy on CBS, beginning with The Big Bang Theory, followed by Life in Pieces, Mom, and the new comedy, Angel from Hell, starring Jane Lynch. It all starts Thursday, 8, 7 Central, only CBS.
Hasn't played well in the second half, but still has 18 points and 15 rebounds. And you can't tell a ton about how he's going to look in an NBA floor, because you've called NBA games, it's so much more opened up because you have so much more offensive talent. But one thing you can learn about Ben Simmons is the competitive aptitude. Here down to, as we mentioned, only the fourth true road game he's ever played in his competitive life.
There's just such an effortless nature about his game, the way he plays. Just kind of glides through the floor as Finney Smith is fouled. Both
elegant
teams in the bonus.
Elegant.
Simmons, the 19-year-old phenom. And now big free throws for Finney Smith. John Igbunu has gone to the Gators bench, picked up his fourth. Finney Smith hits a big free throw here, 64% free throw shooter for the senior out of Portsmouth, Virginia. See the bandage on his upper lip. Four-point Gators lead. Well, how does LSU respond in hostile territory? Blakeney errant again. Offensive rebound, Robinson. The tip from Simmons won't go, and Rimmer clears. LSU has really started to pull away on the glass. They're out-rebounding Florida 43-33, but they're still down four. Chioza. Finney Smith. The senior turns a little bit too strong. Ball saved underneath by Leon. What a play to get a fresh 30. Now the officials quickly blow the whistle.
Trying to make sure it hit the rim, which it did. I think it was an inadvertent whistle because they're just trying to make sure that ball made contact with the rim on the jump shot, which it did on the weak side of the basket.
So 28 to shoot, 5:14 to play, second half. Chioza, the sophomore from Memphis, will reset. Leon from deep. His second three of the afternoon. Simmons underneath for Robinson, who's fouled.
Well, this is simple basketball, but this is what Leon, as a stretch four, kind of brings to the table. Watch him rotate up so when the roll man demands help, Hornsby helps just enough. A laser pass to Leon, splash, and the Gators extend their lead to 7 points.
Here's Elbert Robinson, two free throws. Only 7 of 15 at the line on the season. Sophomore from Garland, Texas.
This is the problem with Craig Victor in foul trouble. He's a very good rebounder, but a poor free throw shooter and a non-offensive player.
Here comes Kayvon Allen underneath, dropping a dime to Zimmer, and he'll shoot free throws. Boy, how quickly did Kayvon Allen get down the floor?
This is all Kayvon Allen. And Kayvon Allen just pushes, and he sees Robinson back. That's just effort. And what was missing this week when they played Wednesday in Knoxville has not been missing this Saturday in Gainesville.
So here's Rimmer at the free throw line. He's battled some back injuries. He's been on the shelf much of the last couple of weeks. It's a critical free throw here as Greg Victor comes back in. Can't waste any more time if you're Johnny Jones. Down 8.
They've just had no offense. The defense has been better, although they're still getting beat up on the glass. They haven't had any offense here the last 5 minutes of the game.
Here comes Simmons. Contact, and he's headed to the free throw line. The freshman Simmons putting LSU on his back, a chance to cut it to 6.
Will you take over a game? That's the question for Ben Simmons. Is he willing to take over a game and score? And the answer is yes. As Justin Leon gets caught reaching, that's where the foul was. Chance to cut it back to 6.
Simmons, 20-plus points, 4 of his last 5 games. Already a double-double today as he hits the 20-point plateau to go along with 15 rebounds. Just another day at the office for the freshman stud out of Melbourne, Australia. Gioza backs away, resets. We come up on 4 minutes to play. 10 to shoot. Finney Smith. Gioza from 3. Good box out from Victor.
I was just going to say the same thing. Outstanding box out. If I'm LSU, I go small here. I take Craig Victor out of the game. Simmons going to get 2 free throws when we come back.
6-point Gators lead on CBS. Tomorrow, a big-time matchup in the Big Ten when Mark Loving and the Buckeyes battle Yogi Ferrell and the Hoosiers right here on the road to the Final Four, CBS Sports. Happy to have you with us on this wild card Saturday in the NFL. 6-point lead for the Florida Gators.
Well, we told you this game was about Ben Simmons and the AT&T Fast Analysis. Pretty easy to analyze. Guy can really pass the basketball with his left or his right hand. He's been outstanding driving to the basket. Didn't have a turnover the first half, 6 in the second half. But Simmons is trying to bring the Tigers back. They have trailed essentially the entire way. He's got a career-high 15 rebounds to go with 21 points and 4 assists.
That was our AT&T Fast Analysis. If you just kind of checked in and have been watching intermittently, those numbers may have caught you by surprise. 21-15. Also the assist numbers. He has struggled with some turnovers, 5 of them in the second half. But you could just see the brilliance of this kid's game. A freshman trying to cut into this deficit with under 4 minutes left. Mike White, Finney Smith, Gioza. The freshman, Kayvon Allen, Devin Robinson, and John Agudu back on the floor. Robinson had the space. Wants to run some clock. Heady play.
They want to get the ball inside to Agudu, and where Florida has really done a good job is on the offensive glass.
Gioza. Robinson on a 3. Critical miss.
What
a rebound
great
pull
job
by Blakeney.
Yeah, Blakeney did an outstanding job defensively, then blocked out Agudu.
LSU down 4. Quarterman underneath to Victor. Still plenty of time to shoot. Quarterman resets. Porterman, the junior from Savannah, Georgia, trying to find an opening. Pulls up for three, nearly banked in. Benny Smith clears.
What a selfish shot.
Excellent defense by the Gators. This did not give him much space.
The ball never left his hands. It was a four-point game. Get the ball moving.
Gators, by the way, just six turnovers today. Benny Smith couldn't finish. Simmons just throws it up against two, and he gets it to go.
Chioza couldn't have played that any better. Simmons is left-handed, likes to finish with his right hand. Chioza guessed correctly, played perfect defense, and found a way to make a shot.
25 for Simmons. It's a two-point game. And Boone is fouled on a catch. And that is number five on Victor. He is fouled out.
There's Simmons. Chioza guesses correctly, perfect defense. Just one of those very fortunate shots. Simmons likes those little runners with his right hand.
How big a loss is this for LSU? Victor done for the day.
I think it's big, but I would not replace him with a big. I would go small as the brain trust is discussing things.
Johnny Jones, the head coach, flanked by his assistants, his lead assistant, David Patrick. And they decide to go big here. Aaron Epps, the 6'9 forward. And of Ball, Louisiana, will check in. We haven't seen much of him today.
Yeah, Brendan Sur was really advising. Of course, Brendan Sur has spent the greater part of his professional life in the NBA. I'm sure Sur was trying to discuss the possible matchups. Igbunu's a mismatch for whomever they throw in.
Igbunu, a kid who really struggles at the free throw line. It was one of his first six before that make to extend it to a three-point lead.
Yeah, but what's he shooting for?
57%.
Right, so he's bound to make these to get close to his average, right?
Steps up, calmly hits two with the game hanging in the balance. Simmons has hit LSU's last 9 points. Knocked out of his hands and stolen by Igbunu.
Remember, you had a 30-second shot clock. Still no time for LSU to panic. But if you're LSU, five guys have to commit to rebounding the basketball.
So that stat. Wardip maintaining the lead despite struggling with his shot last couple of minutes. Igbunu, nice drop step. Up off last. No. It's loose. Blakeney the rebound. Here come the Tigers. Outside Hornsby for three. No. The tip by Simmons. No.
Simmons get that ball.
And he's headed to the free throw line. Simmons can cut it to one with a buck 17 remaining.
How did he get this basketball? Antonio Blakeney, outstanding pass. Simmons pushing, shoving, tipping. Guy on the floor just grabs with his left hand and throws it in. Wow.
The basketball prodigy from Melbourne, 28 points to go along with 17 rebounds. And he has scored the Tigers' last 12 points. They are within one.
Florida has two timeouts left.
1 minute, 1 minute remaining.
Final 60 seconds. You can sense the restlessness from this sellout crowd in Gainesville. Igbunu, baby hook shot. Committed by Simmons, and all seven have come since halftime.
Now they're backing off. Dorian Finney-Smith daring him to shoot. He pump fakes. And yeah, that's a travel. You know, if he'd simply hand the ball off to Blakeney or hand the ball off to Hornsby, they'd have a wide open shot because there's no one there in help.
Mike White signaling for time from the Florida bench. Tight moments in Gainesville. Coming up after the game, time permitting, we'll send you to New York. Adam Clark and Seth standing by with Inside College Basketball, presented by Progressive, as they update you on all of the college basketball action around the country. Johnny Jones and LSU trying to build off their monumental victory over Kentucky at home on Tuesday, but right now down three with 29.8 left.
And I'd expect LSU to try and pressure, maybe even trap here on a ball screen late. Cristioza has tried to get the ball inside to Johnny Bunu almost the entire second half.
Whistle blown.
Just foul him away from the ball. That's a smart play. And Bunu, who you mentioned, four free throw shooter, did make his last two. And LSU fouls him intentionally without fouling him intentionally, if you get my drift.
At the line, Johnny Bunu.
Derek Bunu, a 57% free throw shooter, 3 of 8 this afternoon. Born in Nigeria, moved to the States, started his high school career in Atlanta, before moving to Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Boy, he's hit some big free throws and has maintained his composure despite a couple of misses on that last trip. Massive free throws and a two-possession lead for the Gators. 21 seconds left. Quarterman, Simmons, Hornsby with Epps and Blakeney. Offensive foul against LSU.
On Ben Simmons. They wanted Ben Simmons to run what's called a pin down. So he passes the ball in and goes and screens for Hornsby. Hornsby didn't wait on the screen. See Simmons, he's running, never sets his feet. That's a weak call.
You didn't like that, huh?
No.
Fourth personal on Simmons. Benny Smith can't find anyone, and now they have to burn a timeout. So 17.2 to play. Gators trying to put this one on ice. Up 5 on CBS.
Gators with a 5-point lead. You be the judge, Spirit. You just watch Ben Simmons come and set a simple pin down screen on Devon Walker. Did he move or was he set? Byron Jarrett had a better angle than I did, but I don't think that's a good play.
Tough call to take as Gioza is fouled by Simmons, and that is his fifth. Simmons has fouled out. Well, certainly had his moments. Brilliant final stat line. 28 points, 17 rebounds, 4 assists, but 7 turnovers committed by Simmons, all coming in the second half.
Yeah, several of them on offensive fouls, too. Three of them on offensive fouls. And that's one of those you have to have your eye on the fouls and have your staff tell you he's got 4 personal fouls. If you're going to foul in the press, he either can't be in or has to be in the back of the press.
First free throw from Chioza, 80% free throw shooter.
Difficulty in winning on the road in any league. In the SEC, no different.
The Gators are going to erase the bitter taste of that blowout loss in Knoxville on Wednesday, as they will get their second SEC victory in front of a raucous crowd here at Gainesville. Florida wins it 68-62. They hand the Tigers LSU's first conference loss.
Now they were the better team, tipped the finish, even though they went through a stretch in the second half where they couldn't find the basket with a GPS. Their defense, their intensity, their rebounding, and Johnny Bunu making free throws late seal the deal for Mike White's Gators.
Coming up tonight on CBS, it's the AFC wildcard game between the Pittsburgh Steelers and Cincinnati Bengals, beginning with a special playoff edition of the NFL Today at 7:30 Eastern Time. Now for Doug Gottlieb, our entire crew, Spiro Dinas saying so long from Gainesville. The final, Gators 68, Tigers 62. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports. Coming up next, Inside College Basketball, presented by Progressive.